All right, good morning. Welcome, everybody.
Good morning.
We're going to get started here. We'll go over some announcements quick, and then we'll pray before we start service. Just want to welcome everybody. Thanks for joining us today. Wow, what a beautiful day. I don't know what everybody else thinks. I guess it's getting cool out now, but this is my favorite time of year. I love this. It could be like this all year round. Of course, I don't know, maybe I'd miss the warm weather and I'd want warm weather. But I love this cool weather. This is just awesome. Awesome sleeping weather. So, yeah, just thank you for joining us today. We welcome everybody, and just those who join us live on Facebook, we just welcome you and just thank you. And as Pastor always says, yeah, give a shout out there, a like, and so other people can see, and then maybe they'll join us. All right, we'll start with some announcements. I'm going to go over these quick for the people joining us live, because everybody can read the announcements up here. So hopefully everybody is aware of what's going on. So September 13th is today. We had our meeting today. We had our first meeting to discuss the October Fall Fest. What's it called? October 3rd Fall Fest. So if you're interested in helping with that, we're getting now we're through the women's retreat, which was a great success, which is amazing. The God used that in people's lives. We're just so thankful for that. We just so now we want to start on our new outreach to glorify God, to draw people, and just to continue to bring souls to Christ in whatever way we can. So we're looking forward to that. Like I said, we had a meeting this morning, and I think it went well. I had to leave in the middle of it, so we're starting to plan that. So if you're interested at all in helping, especially if you're available to help, we ask that you would just, I would say, see Kim Hurd at this point, until I know somebody else is in charge of it. But anyway, see Kim or Pastor, and just let them know that you're interested and you want to help and you're available on that day. So today after service, we will be removing the pews from the church. So if anybody can stay to help with that, that'd be greatly appreciated. Thursday the 17th, we will be having a Facebook Live service. No service here because the church will be closed for painting. They'll be painting the ceilings in here. That's an awesome thing. We can get these ceilings painted, then we can continue to move forward. Get the chairs in here, get set up to do different activities. So then Saturday the 19th, we have a ladies' meeting at 9 a.m. here at the church, and we have a men's meeting at 9 a.m. in Cafe 101. And then immediately following those Bible studies, we'll have a workday cleanup here, just to clean up after the painting, after the demolition, as far as cleaning up things in here from the painting taking place. But and then we'll be moving the chairs into the chapel. So everybody's welcome to stay and help with that. And then after service next Sunday, the 20th, we'll be having soul winning on the street immediately following service. So you're welcome to join us for that. And also we'll be having a youth meeting. And then everybody mark your calendars. Remember, if you're not already signed up, if you're not participating in a couples retreat, which is September 25th through the 27th, remember that there will be no service here on the 27th, because the majority of the people involved in church service will be away at the couples retreat. So just pray about that. Just think about that if you're not already involved in that. Just like I said, and the next big thing, October 3rd, that's it for this month, and October 3rd will be the Fall Fest. We'll be closing down the street out here for the day, and just having activities like food, games, fellowship, and sharing the word, sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. So welcoming people in the community, and hopefully people into the church here. Okay, is there anything else that we need to announce at this time? Okay, well, we'll start, before I pray then, we'll go to the Greater Grace World Outreach Missions prayer focus. And this month of September is focusing on Europe. So specifically for today, the prayer request is for UK, specifically London. And it says, pray that the newly saved grow and to become rooted in the Word. And for more souls and disciples, Bible college semester students, work and family schedules. For youth coping with lockdown isolation, and wisdom as we wait on the Lord in regard to future missions trips. And pastors there in London are Pastor Tony and Joyce Morley, and Pastor Alistair and Kathy Craddock. So just continue to keep the churches, the missionaries throughout the world in your prayers, especially specifically in Europe for this month. And especially, just missionaries and churches throughout the world who are not just Greater Grace, but any church, any ministry that's basically sharing the gospel, sharing the word of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ throughout the world. Let's pray. Father, we do lift up specifically the church in London to you, Father, and we pray that you would just continue to draw people to yourself through that ministry, God. We pray that the people that have come in, newly come in, God, that you would just root them in that ministry in your word, Father, that your word will give them new life, new freedom, new liberties in this world today, that just with everything's going on, just this pastor spoke the other night, there's so much confusion, there's so much doubt, there's so much fear in this world, God. We just pray that your ministries will continue to grow throughout the world, that your ministries will continue to reveal Christ to people in this dying world, Father. We just pray that you would just touch the hearts of those people, just touch the leaders, protect them from the evil in the world, protect them from the viruses, protect them, keep them healthy, Father, so they can continue to go forward in serving you and ministering to people there in London, God. And we pray special for this ministry, Father, here in Bowling Springs. We just thank you for this building that you gave us. We thank you for those who were in this place before us. We just thank you for their lives, their love, and their faith in you, Father. We just thank you for this opportunity that we can come in here. We can open up our hearts, open up our minds, open up our this body, this church, to the people in this community, Father. And we just pray that you would continue to teach us through your word, through our awesome pastor that we have here, and through any man or woman that stands at this pulpit, God. We just pray that you would fill us with your spirit, fill us with your word, fill us with your knowledge and wisdom, so we can continue to go forward in faith and hope in your grace, your mercy, and love for each one of us, God. We just pray that you would continue to use us for your glory, continue to strengthen us, continue to lead us. And if it's your will, Father, to strengthen us and build us in numbers, Father, that we can just as we've been hearing through your word, that we can build unity, we can build oneness, and we can build a faith in you, God, in this world that's been lost and gone for so long, Father. And we just pray now that you would just bless each one here today. Bless those who join us on Facebook Live. And just bless those special who need physical healings today, who aren't able to be with us for whatever reason, whether it's work or other activities are going on. We do pray for Shane and Becky today as they're traveling. God, we just pray that you would just give them
Yeah, just peace, joy, and fellowship with you today, God, wherever they're at. Just minister to them, Father. Just allow this time away just to be a blessing to them, Father. We just pray now that you just bless each one here. Just bless this time together. Just allow this time together just to be glory unto you, God. That we can come in this place, that we can be separated from the things of the world, that we can just have a fellowship, a oneness, a time of rest with you, Father. Just bless each one of us now. We pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Pray that we would have divine concentration today. God, that the Holy Spirit would guide us and teach us today, and that we would have divine attention to your word and to the message that you have for us today, to a word given in season for each one of us today. God, no matter what condition we're in, no matter what state we're in, Father, that you will meet us right where we are, God, in our weakness and our frailty. God, that you reveal our weakness to us, not to condemn us, but to show us the need that we have for you, God. And we just pray today, God, that we would respond to that positively, God. Not react, but that we would respond to your word, that respond to your act of kindness for each one of us, God, and allow you to penetrate us with the Holy Spirit, penetrate us with the word, Father, that we would respond and allow you to perform the work that you have for each one of us, the plan that you have laid out for each one of us, God. God, bless this time today. Use it for your glory, God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Dear Lord God, please anoint Pastor John today to preach your sermon today to the congregation. Please anoint our ears to receive your word gladly, dear Lord God. Please bless the offering today, and please bless our service. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Today I'd like to talk about prophecy in God's word, which is the Bible. Bible prophecy is strong evidence that God's word is authoritative, so we can regard the Bible's commandments and doctrines as the barometer by which we base our beliefs and our conduct in our lives. We recognize the Bible to be God's word, and as such that it is absolute and infallible and inerrant word, the inerrant word handed down to mankind from him personally, as divinely inspired and communicated to the writers by him. When we read Bible prophecy and we recognize how God's prophetic word manifests itself just the way God has predicted in his word, this demonstrates how God knows the future and is in full control of every element of mankind's activities in this world. The political events of the nations of this world will play out on the worldwide stage of events, just as God has foretold in his prophetic word. This evidence should enable us to witness that the sovereign God of the universe is involved intimately in the affairs of our planet. We profess the words of Scripture to be God's words given to men, but not only did he give his words to men, God has promised to preserve his word, which he has. Let us consider today several Bible passages that have foretold God's word accurately and prophesied about our current geopolitical events as they unfold in front of our eyes in our present day and age, just as predicted even thousands of years ago. If we desire to consider whether the things going on in this present world are sufficient validation of the accuracy of Bible prophecy, we only need to start by examining his chosen country and his people Israel, and his chosen city Jerusalem, and the role they have played out scripturally in prophecy, and how these prophecies are being fulfilled right in front of our eyes in life, our lifetimes today. Things we often watch on TV or perhaps read about news briefs. Bible prophecy has God's prophetic timestamp on it, and God's word happens exactly as it's foretold and at the exact time it's foretold to happen. As we pay attention, we can see from current events that God's plan is coming together fully. If we want confirmation that God shows us the future through his word, most often we can look towards Israel and Jerusalem for the unfolding of these events, as God's people, God's chosen city, in that he's placed his name on them both and chosen both. My devotional today focuses specifically on Israel and even more specifically on Jerusalem for evidence of his complete prophetic fulfillment as prophesied in his prophetic word.